So, one of the reasons I really like the idea of doing reviews, either trailer or movies, is that I think that movies and in pop culture tend to make for a really great impetus for discussions. And I was actually really surprised at my Ghostbuster trailer review at how much discussion it actually garnered, and some pretty interesting topics came up, especially regarding the fact of Sony deleting comments. And I kind of knew that they were deleting comments just because of what people were saying in the commentaries, like, hey, my comments were deleted, hey, my comments were deleted. But I originally thought that maybe they were just deleting all the negative comments and trying to put all, you know, garner all the positive comments in. But a couple of people actually left comments in my trailer review, basically stating that actually Sony is trying to bank on the idea of sexism to sell their movie. As in, if you're not sexist, you'll go see this movie, or if you're not a misogynistic pig, you'll go see this movie. Otherwise, you are. And I found that a pretty interesting topic of discussion, because I don't put it past corporations to do stuff like this. I definitely don't. When you have millions of dollars riding on the line, why wouldn't you, right? I mean, it's not like these big movie studios are, you know, altruistic and generous and loving and care about the people. It's about numbers. One of my favorite YouTube videos to watch is The Hollywood Reporter. And they do these roundtable discussions. And one of my favorite ones to watch is the executive producer ones or the director ones. And a lot of times they'll talk about pretty cool stuff about what it takes to make a movie. And sometimes, especially with the studio execs, how the numbers play in to actually determine what they're going to make, why they'll make it, you know, why they'll put out something like Fantastic Four, even though they know they don't have what it takes to actually, you know, do it. Because a lot of future money is riding on it, a lot of bullet points are checked, and there's a spreadsheet that's actually used, and that's how movies are made, and, you know, by the numbers. And so, yeah, I mean, Sony using some sort of marketing ploy to get you to watch their movie, whoa, big shocker. But I did find it interesting because I didn't actually see that at first. But I got a comment from Rplay, and he or she said, unfortunately, a lot of the debate has been going towards the whole female aspect. I think that was my comment. And then they replied, actually, that seems to be designed by Sony. I was up around 5 a.m. and saw the trailer, and most of the negative comments were, you know, reasonable, with some sexist stuff here and there. A few hours in, all the topics were suddenly sexist things. Then I was like, the feminist blogs are going to eat that up. And I Googled around, and sure enough, in a few hours, they lapped all the sexist comments up. Then a few hours later, up to now, it's been a general shaving down of negative comments while still leaving sexist stuff around for a bit. It seems to be Sony's emergency plan to stage a scenario where outrage towards the film is just the misogynist. Ignore those crazies or go see our movie. That was a really awesome comment. You kind of say, well, maybe people are just making this up. And I just was like, who would come to a YouTube channel that has less than 1,000 subscribers and make stuff up? It doesn't make any sense. Obviously, a person is invested in this idea that maybe the movie sucks because it sucks, that it has nothing to do with sexism, and that it's kind of slimy and shitty that Sony is deciding to pull this ploy and make this all about sexism and feminism, and really bringing down the idea of feminism, especially in a time where I feel like it's very important to keep a positive message about, you know, female equality and not make it, just so trivial as, like, people don't like Ghostbusters because it has an all-female cast. And then there's another follow-up, two more follow-up replies. I'll just go ahead and read those. Sniff Heinkel says, of course it was done on purpose. They knew it. If they caused drama by accusing fans of being sexist, they would get feminists to support the film. I knew that was what they planned as soon as I saw Paul Figgs, Twitter calling Ghostbuster fans misogynistic. And now you have people saying, oh, you just don't like it because you hate women. It worked brilliantly. And then Faithion said, I had the top comment at about 7 million views with 150 likes. Needless to say, I was monitoring the comments closely. My comment was deleted along with others that went on to reach over 500 likes. They, like me, did not mention gender, noting instead the use of CGI, slapstick humor, and lack of serious tone. Sony intentionally allowed comments about gender and bigotry to remain. They would summarily mass delete all responses to the comment, allowing the initial upvoted statement to remain. But yes, great comments again. It's pretty amazing. I mean, that, you know, someone with 150 likes on their comments would get it deleted when all they were doing was just basically critiquing the movie and stating that they didn't like it based off of the use of comedy, they didn't find it funny, or that the CGI looked a little lacking, and it did. And I'm just wondering if, like, why Sony would use such a negative message to sell? And I would say that, well, just as Arplay said, it's the emergency backup plan. Oh, the movie really, really sucks, and we're not going to be able to sell this movie just based on, you know, the merit of it being a Ghostbusters film. So I hang on. This is great water cooler chat, by the way. I love it. I love water cooler chat. It's fun, and I think that it's very relevant to have cool discussions using kind of a very soft medium like movies to garner discussions about this. And the fact that Sony is trying to garner negative commentary based off sexism to promote a movie just goes against the whole idea of, like, feminist power in the first place, right? Women equality. And so sure enough, I looked up, movie news and stuff regarding the Ghostbusters trailer and, you know, sexism, etc. And I came across the Washington Post article written on March 4th that states, people hate the Ghostbusters trailer. And yes, it's because it stars women. And they cited comments that were left on the trailer, YouTube trailer, like, women are just incapable of being funny. What a terrible idea. Feminists ruin the world. Shouldn't they be in the kitchen? Did this just become a chick flick? I'll call the real Ghostbusters instead. And I was just like, wow, so Arplay and Sniff Heinkel and Phoebeon were correct. Yep, that's exactly what they were doing. They're banking on this being saying in the news as just kind of hanging on by a thread by this idea that maybe it's not just because of the bad film that it's being knocked so heavily. I mean, the downvotes or the dislikes on that video are just, the ratio of likes to dislike are kind of crazy. Okay, if we're talking about progression, right? A progressive movie, just look at the trailer. We'll break it down, you know, in terms of far as progression for women. Of course, everyone noticed this. Everyone commented on this. Leslie Jones, if you're going to be progressive, why would you have the black female actress play the typical loud black trope that is always accompanied with women in comedy, black women in comedy? Why not make her the really super smart one, the scientist? And then you have, like, Chris Hemsworth, who's, like, supposed to be the male Janine, right? And he's only in the trailer for, I think, like, a second and a half. It doesn't even last very long. But in that second and a half, he kicks more ass than all the female parts combined in the rest of the trailer. I don't understand why it couldn't have been Kate McKinnon who had kicked in that door and just looked like a total badass, you know? Just kicked it in, like, charged in, was serious. Like, you knew she was gonna, you know, bust some fucking ghost ass. Nope, it's Chris Hemsworth's character. Who's supposed to be, you know, if he's supposed to be the Janine, he's supposed to be ditzy. He's supposed to be, why isn't he the one who, instead of Melissa McCarthy touching the and getting zapped, you know, because she's so clumsy, why isn't he the one doing that, right? Like, if you want to break typical stereotypes. And then you have, you know, Kristen Wiig's character, who's supposed to be the super, super smart scientist, and yet she looks homely. You know, you're like, if you're going to break stereotypes. Why is the boring chick who has no fashion sense that's the really smart one? I mean, if you're gonna be progressive, be progressive. And it's just not. I mean, nothing in this trailer spells out anything new. And I think that, you know, it speaks volumes. And I think people aren't stupid. They see that. They're seeing that. And they're just sort of looking at this, you know, this trailer. Yes, it's just 2 minutes. The movie could be completely different. Trailers are cut different from the director. So it's not the director who cuts these things. So yes, I realize that the movie could be completely different, but the trailer is what's being used to sell the movie. So if you want people to go see the movie, this is what you're trying to sell them. And what they're trying to sell us is pretty boring, pretty typical, not funny, not original, and kind of a backslap to the original Ghostbusters. And I think that's what makes people really, really mad. And I just actually checked the comments on the Sony's website for Ghostbusters trailer. And sure enough, I don't think they can keep up with deleting just the negative commentary. Because I looked a couple days ago, and yes, the sexist comments were just like, you know, they were just everywhere, you know, just like, you know, stuff about women giving blowjobs and, you know, women who should be just cleaning house, etc. Those were all at the top. And now, like, because the comments are flooding in, that I think that, you know, they can't keep up and the comments are just basically negative. They're negative, you know, they're negative comments criticizing the trailer for either poor CGI, being not funny, using stereotypical tropes that are unoriginal and lazy, borrowing lines from like Tommy Boy, etc., like things like that. So I, you know, they're not, I don't even think they can keep up with this facade so much, or either that, or maybe just people have gotten to the point where they're like, we're just going to hate on this movie. I don't know, you know, like I doubt it. I think that just people just don't like it. All right. So anyways, thank you so much for the awesome commentary. I really appreciate it. It was a really awesome discussion and I look forward to more. You guys rock. I really enjoyed your input. If you guys would like to see more, you can click right here to watch my Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon 2 sort of Destiny review. Yes, I'm hoping to have more reviews coming up pretty soon. And I'm actually working on an It Man review. Or you can click right here and see my Ghostbusters trailer review. Thanks again for watching, guys. Until next time, see you on the flip side.